Fun with flags.
All right, that's it. All right, hi parents. I'm really honored and pleasure to have Teacher Dana with me. Teacher Dana is a really dedicated teacher and who has years of experience teaching in Taiwan, and I have to translate it.
Sure. Okay.
今天很荣幸请到 Dana 老师过来。 Dana 老师在台湾有很多年的教学经验，而且他是一个非常认真，就是我们的理念非常相同。他是一个很负责的老师。 And I witnessed Teacher Dana's dedication to teaching in an incident. Remember where a home teacher came to me and asked me to act as an interpreter to translate what she had to say to you. And basically, what happened was some of the kids were not happy because they're not getting the correct answers. Mm-hmm. Their parents were not happy to look at their books, they had their mistakes. How come you don't have all the correct answers? And then this is how I get to know that Teacher Dana has a has his ideology of what a good teacher is, okay, and how students should learn instead of just giving them the answers. Now, 有一次有一个老师来请我当翻译，就是反映说要跟老师反映一些问题。那个问题就是有些学生他们的课本里面有一些错误，是因为老师没给他们答案。那家长看到了也很生气，因为他们发现课本里面为什么是 有些题目是没有答案的，那是因为电脑老师不想要给他们答案，就是他们如果没有付出努力的话，他不想只是给他们答案，把答案抄下来，然后大家都很开心就结束了。他有他自己的坚持跟理念。 So would you like to start from there?
Sure. Regarding that incident.
Mm-hmm.
Well, regarding that incident and in general, I believe that students learn by doing, not by copying, and that there's nothing wrong with being wrong. You learn from your mistakes.
Yeah, as long as you learn from the mistakes.
Exactly. It's much better to be wrong and learn why it's wrong than to copy an answer down.
And to just wait for the answers to come to you.
Exactly. If you're not thinking about it, not doing it, you're not learning. And that goes for everything I do in class. I try to get the students to do as much of the work as possible, whether it be previewing or reading the material at home, using the dictionaries. The more the student does, the more they internalize the material that they're reading.
那个电脑老师不给他们答案的原因，是因为很多学生他们都会不自己去思考，然后也没有努力。做错的话没有关系，因为如果你的答案是错的，但是没有经过思考，没有付出时间想要去了解题目在问什么，然后你最后写错的话，那个不是重点。我们都从错误中学习。 但是电脑老师不希望学生就是有一种态度，就是你就给我答案，你就把答案抄下来。那答案都抄下来，都抄对了，但是其实这个过程中是没有学到东西的。So
yeah, once the student has gained somewhat of a knowledge of the vocabulary, I can use the class time to practice using those words that they've learned on their own, either through conversations, role plays, activities. If I'm just standing at the front of the class explaining words, I don't think that's really useful to the students. They can do that on their own, and we can use the class time doing fun things to use that language.
Yeah, exactly. 那电脑老师他有另外一个坚持，就是有一些学生可以在家里自己做的，比如说去查这个单字的意思，在家里可以做到，那他就会把这个当做功课派给学生，然后去把单字的意思搞清楚。那在课堂上的话，老师就不用当字典，要告诉你每个单字的意思，这样就会浪费了很多的时间。那老师就可以做一些比较有意义、更有趣的活动，例如说我们 把学到的单字，我们拿来造句，用不同的情境来运用这些单字，真的做到学以致用，而不是只是等着别人给你答案。Yeah,
I guess I feel strongly that the more the student is responsible for their learning, the better the end result will be, because they're not always going to have an English language speaker around them to help them with things. So if they can develop good study habits when they're younger and develop their vocabulary as they get older, much easier to progress in the language.
So do you agree that vocabulary at this point would be more important than grammar?
I agree vocabulary is the most important thing. Grammar is more like a plan, but you need the words. If you don't have the words, all the grammar in the world is
Because in Taiwan, a lot of teachers are obsessed with grammar. If you look at the textbooks they're using in senior high school, junior high schools, yes, everything's about grammar.
Yeah, grammar's it's important, but it's not as important as understanding the words and knowing how to use them correctly. Grammar comes with repetition and practice. If you focus too much on grammar, you create an environment of fear of being making a mistake.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
So you don't really want people to be afraid of speaking. You want
them to... They're always worried about their friend.
Yeah, and they're too... Many students are too afraid to speak because they don't want to be wrong. You can still communicate your thoughts clearly without using perfect grammar. Grammar is a guide to making
yourself clear. And also that grammar comes with speaking. You know, as long as you learn to speak correctly, you learn to correct your mistakes as you speak, you're going to pick up grammar along the way.
Yeah,
it's about like learning the rules, and you have to memorize a lot of different sets of rules that are actually conflicting sometimes.
Yeah, grammar is more of a set of suggestions and rules. It's important, but it's not as important as expressing your thoughts clearly. And you can do that with or without correct grammar. Grammar is not the most important thing when it comes to communicating your thoughts.
Well, let me see if I remember everything you just said.
Yeah, that's a lot, sorry.
在教学方面, 丁老师的坚持是学生应该要有责任感，应该要为自己的学习负责。因为如果你有良好的学习习惯的话，其实在学习上的话就会突飞猛进。那如果你的学习习惯是不好，或者你的态度是不对的，那可能在学习上的话，事情就会事倍功半，事情做很多但是看不到预期的效果。然后他也提到，在学英文的过程中，其实单字量是最重要的。 如果你的单字量够，你会去把单字去自用的话，那才是你英文应该要做的部分。然后在台湾的话，可能很多的教材的编写，还有很多老师的传统的理念，就是文法很重要，文法很重要，就花很多时间教文法。那导致丁老师观察到的就是，学生文法学的越多，越不敢开口说英文，因为担心自己的文法会用错。现在是现在时，还是过去式？ 还是现在完成式到底要怎么讲？那越害怕，他不敢去用，不敢去用的话，那他的文法就不会进步。可是他又要背很多的文法规则，这是一个很奇怪的现象。
Yeah, I think the most important thing is having students not be afraid to communicate their thoughts, right or wrong. If you're going to communicate your thoughts incorrectly, that's just as good as correctly because you will still learn from your mistakes. Another thing, I don't really like to focus on one because like one area. I think that reading and writing and speaking and listening, they all reinforce each other. So you need to do a little bit of everything.
Yeah, not reading,
not focus too much on reading alone or the grammar.
And in fact, in Taiwan, a lot of reading has become grammar lessons.
Yeah.
You know, they start to read. I saw this letter, the book that, that students have, Three Little Pigs. And they can go into grammar when they teach Three Little Pigs, like Three Little Pigs, oh, it's plural. Three pigs. And they go on to explain every sentence, the grammar of every sentence. Wow, that's amazing.
No, grammar is important, but it shouldn't be the most important thing.
文法很重要，但是文法不应该是最重要的一个东西。英文的话有听说读写的技能，那我们听说读写的技能应该都综合，不只是把那个阅读当作是最重要的，然后又把阅读变成是文法教学的课程这样子，这样子的话其实是很单调的。 And what is your view on the use of Chinese in English classes?
I think as long as it's used to make something more clear, there's no problem using Chinese in class, as long as it's used only to make something more clear in English. If you're speaking Chinese all the time, that's not really useful. But as a tool, yes, I think
like
Chinese should be used.
One or two concepts, that's fine.
Because one of the factors, one of the problems with learning English is time. You don't have a lot of time. So if you can save 10 minutes by saying something in Chinese, I think it's a great idea.
然后丁老师的那个想法蛮，我觉得蛮，特别的，就是跟一般的外师可能不太一样。我问他说：“你认为在上英文课的时候可以用中文吗？”他说：“当然可以。如果说是为了厘清一些概念，例如说有一个东西我必须用英文解释的话，因为你听不懂我在解释的英文，所以可能这个很简单的一个概念，例如说地心引力，我们就搞了10分钟。但是如果可以让你允许某个学生讲中文。” 跟另外一个学生解释的话，他们就省下了课堂上10分钟的时间。他认为这样子何乐不为，所以并不是说只有在学英文的时候只能够用全英语的环境，一句中文都不能够讲。那这一方面的话，他反而是比较开明的。
That's about it. That's it.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep. So let's hope that we have a chance to work together.
Okay. Yeah, me too.
Thank you.